I wanted to talk to you guys about a theory I have that Santa Claus causes atheism. Seriously. I'm saying this because I get a lot of emails from atheists. I love getting emails from atheists. I have a lot of friends that are atheists. I used to be an atheist. Atheist, 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 atheist. But I get these emails from atheists, and they always say the same thing about Santa Claus. So I've investigated it, I've studied this, and I have come to the conclusion that Santa Claus causes atheism. Let me explain. In my correspondence with atheists, the email will go something like this. I'll be talking to them about the Bible, and I'll show them all these historical prophecies that have come true that the Bible predicted, and the prophecy that is about to come true, a one world government, one world monetary system. As you guys know, China just called for a one world global currency. And I'll bring these type of things up to atheists as we talk, and they'll come back and they'll say, well, yeah, you probably believe in Santa Claus too. And they're very upset. Like, you could tell their sadness in their voice and despair. So here's my theory of what happened, because they always bring up Santa Claus. My theory is that Santa, that's right, good old Saint Nick, has caused atheism. I believe that an atheist is someone that believed in Santa, and then they found out there is no Santa, and so their world is crushed, and they're very upset about that. Extremely upset. They're extremely upset. So now they're like, well, oh my gosh, well, maybe God's like Santa. And they're like so mad that because maybe they, you know, really loved Santa, and now to have the rug pulled out from them like that, they're just crushed by it. Now, I bring this up because if you ever notice when you talk to atheists, God bless their sweet little hearts, they always say, well, yeah, what about Santa? And they're all sad about it. And then sometimes they'll even bring up the Tooth Fairy. They found out about the Tooth Fairy also, and they're sad about the Tooth Fairy or the Easter Bunny. I've noticed that. So I think what happens is an atheist might be someone that has never outgrown that disappointment when they find out the harsh reality of Santa Claus, the Easter Bunny, and the Tooth Fairy. Look, I was upset too, atheist. I was an atheist myself also. But it had the reverse effect for me. When I found out the secret of Santa, and of course you know that Saint Nick did exist. He's an actual historical person, so further causes salt in the wound for these atheists. But it had the reverse effect for me when I found out that about Santa Claus, the Easter Bunny, the Tooth Fairy. I left all those myths behind. I did not get upset that they were myths. I left them all behind. And now don't get me wrong, I'm not a hypocrite. If it's like Christmas, someone wants to get me a gift and stuff, I'll take it. I don't want to offend them. And I do celebrate Christmas as the birth of Christ and the Easter Bunny. You know, I'm all into peanut butter and chocolate bunnies. I will take it. If it was an atheist holiday and they were giving out peanut butter chocolate, I'd be right there. Yay, atheism! Give me my chocolate bunny. I left atheism to become a Christian, and I don't have anything against Santa or the Easter Bunny or the Tooth Fairy. I didn't get my little feelings hurt. So the next time you, yes you, watching this video or listening to a video about atheism and you correspond to the author of the video, or you make a video about it and the atheists email you back and they sadly bring up their past when they found out the horror of Santa, the Easter Bunny, and the Tooth Fairy, and they say, well, what about Santa, the Easter Bunny, the Tooth Fairy, and they start crying, bring that up to them. Say, look, my friend Shock had the same thing. He got over it. you got to get over your disappointment about Santa, the Tooth Fairy, and the Easter Bunny. Look at that neat scooter. That's all it is. That's all it really is. We keep trying to find this deep meaning why atheists think the way they do. It's the Santa syndrome. That's all it is. It's just they're upset about Santa. Who would have thought that jolly old Saint Nick, I gotta get over here, was the culprit of atheism? Santa causes atheism. And if you want to test this, bring up Santa with an atheist in a conversation and they go ballistic. You're bringing up bad memories. So I'm warning you, if you bring up Santa with an atheist, oh my gosh, prepare to have a conversation. Like they're going to tell you how the cow ate the cabbage in no uncertain terms. I'm telling you about it. Santa leads to atheism. I've proven it. Oh, by the way, you guys can go to our live Bible study tonight, or even right now, it might be archived, at shotgunnow.net/church. Or you can go ahead and I was waiting for a green light and a green arrow appeared. That surprised me. Or you can, there'll be a bubble popping up on the screen. You can click there. And you guys know me. I am nobody. Just Shock the Dork. The dork that rides on a motorcycle. Nothing above average with me. I'm just an average Joe. But I preach an above average message. And today's message, we found out that Santa leads to atheism. Or we should have named it The Lack of Santa.